Lots going on in the markets today. Overstock was on a massive rampage this morning, up 12. Now, just still having quite the day, up $10 at 125. I told you 3 weeks ago it was going to 100. Now I'm telling you right now, it's going to 200. Not right now, but over the next month or two. The Dow Jones is up 70, 27,850. Can't get through that 28,000 number. It seems to be hitting some resistance here. And people are really looking at this stark contrast between Donald Trump and deregulation and lower taxes and Joe Biden, who all they can say about him is that he's nice, he's kind, he's old, he'll be a uniter, he won't be mad tweeting. This is what they're trying to sell us on. Now, people that I talk to on Wall Street, as soon as they said Kamala Harris was the VP, they were like, all right, that's it. No way this guy gets elected now. There's just no way. She's too much of a vessel. She's too much of a transactional person. And by the way, the African American vote, which is very important to the Democrats, it's like a stalwart for them. 98% of women voted for Hillary last time. But a strange one is like 16% of the African American men voted for Trump, and that's up from like 9% under George W. Bush. So there was almost like a 40-50% increase in African American men. And if you go up to the lead up to the election, minorities were doing as good as anyone, if not better. Lowest unemployment in history, the highest new home sales, highest new business starts. So that community is near and dear to the Democrats, and Donald Trump, by his actions, has made some serious inroads there. Now, let's go to the lineup from last night. Okay, so last night, the night before we talked about it, and it was Bernie Sanders was in the leadoff spot, the American Socialist, who's not even a Democrat, he's a registered independent. He was leading off, talking about the movement that they built. Bernie wasn't talking about Joe Biden's movement. He's talking about his movement. He had a movement. Joe Biden is a man with no country. And then the first night, they rolled out a whole, John Kasich, okay? Talk about irrelevant. Him and Alyssa Milano should start some kind of podcast together. The Alyssa Milano, John Kasich, irrelevant podcast. That's what they should do. They should do irrelevant. John Kasich's a man with no country. He was a never-Trumper who was a sore loser. He had a bitter taste in his mouth. Then he became a Trump hater. And now I guess he's a Democrat. He's standing there talking in a taped message to the Democratic National Convention. They rolled out Susan Molinari. Susan Molinari was a congressman from Staten Island, a rhino all along, another transactional person. I think her husband got all wangled up in the stock loan savings bank scandal way back when. And they're trying to roll out Republicans. And not only Republicans, but non-Democrats, Bernie Sanders and John Kasich. And Susan Molinari somehow. Colin Powell hasn't voted for a Republican in 20 years, but they roll him out like, ooh, look, another one left. And by the way, Colin Powell sat there for right or for wrong and executed a plan against Iraq because of supposedly weapons of mass destruction that turned out not to be there, but still, we did get a tyrant dictator out of office. But okay, let's go through this. Now, last night, they gave Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez a speaking spot, and she got 1 minute. Look how excited she was about Joe Biden and Kamala Harris. Take a look at this.
Bienvenidos, and thank you to everyone here today endeavoring towards a better, more just future for our country and our world. In fidelity and gratitude to a mass people's movement working to establish 21st-century social, economic, and human rights, including guaranteed healthcare, higher education, living wages, and labor rights for all people in the United States. a movement striving to recognize and repair the wounds of racial injustice, colonization, misogyny, and homophobia, and to propose and build reimagined systems of immigration and foreign policy that turn away from the violence and xenophobia of our past. A movement that realizes the unsustainable brutality of an economy that rewards explosive inequalities of wealth for the few at the expense of long-term stability for the many, and who organized a historic grassroots campaign to reclaim our democracy. In a time when millions of people in the United States are looking for deep, systemic solutions to our crises of mass evictions, unemployment, and lack of health care, in el espíritu del pueblo and out of a love for all people, I hereby second the nomination of Senator Bernard Sanders of Vermont for President of the United States of America.
Shocking stuff, okay. Now, here's the good thing. For all you people out there who are stuck in some dead-end job, or, you know, you lost your job due to quarantine, just 2 years ago, Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez was slinging drinks in a bar in Queens. Okay, so hallelujah for that. That's what's great about America, that you can go from bartender to speaking at the Democratic National Convention in just 2 years. Okay, great for that. Notable things. She talked about a historic grassroots campaign to change America. What was historic about it? What was historic about it was the Bernie Sanders movement, which the establishment crushed, okay? And at the very end, if you noticed, mark my words, something sneaky went on right there. She said, I hereby second the nomination for president for Senator Bernard Sanders. She seconded the nomination of Bernie Sanders. I don't know who seconded her nomination, but it wasn't for Joe Biden, that's for sure. And in the whole speech, she did not one time mention the great unity with the great presidential candidate, Joe Biden, and his great vice presidential candidate, Kamala Harris. Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez mentioned none of the ticket running on a Democratic Party, but she did second the nomination for Bernard Sanders, who is not even a Democrat.